Hello, basketball coaches and basketball players. My name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training, and I am going to show you today some of my top five sideline inbounds plays that have won me multiple basketball games. So hello everyone, my name is Alan. If you're new to this channel, on this channel I show you basketball plays, drills, and skills. So if you like that stuff, hit that like button and subscribe. Anyways, today I am going to show you some of the top 5 plays that I have used myself to win basketball games. These are sideline inbounds plays, so let's get down to the clipboard and let's check these out. So in this first basketball play, this one is fairly simple and you've probably seen me show it a few different times. I call this the S play because S stands for shoot. So you would call the player's name out, his initial, his number, whatever, doesn't matter. So let's call player 2. And once that play is called, he is going to run in between these two players. And he's going to pop out to that 3-point line. These players are going to then sandwich down. And he could be and should be open for that 3-point shot. Very simple and very, very effective. Now, in our second basketball inbounds play, we're going to have something very similar, except it's going to be done up here, and we used to call this box S. Mainly, it's a box, and it's the same as the S play. This will really get the other team going because now they think that you're running a different play. However, still kind of is different. So let me explain. This one, instead of going this way out, we're going to be going up top and curling around. This is also going to be a swing play as well. So how we're going to run this is, let's say player 4 is one of the best 3-point shooters we have. And this is our second best 3-point shooter. How we're going to run this is player 2 and 1 are going to sandwich together for player 4. Player 3 is going to inbounds to player 4. And he's going to run inbounds. At this time, what we want is player 5 setting a screen up for player 1 and for this to be a dribble handoff up top. Player 1 is then going to curl around. Player 2 is going to set a second screen for him. And now player 3 could either take that 3-point shot or player 1 may be open and should be open for the 3-point shot as well. Now in our third sideline inbounds play, what we're going to have is player 4 setting a screen for player 2. Player 2 is going to pop up and player 3 is going to inbounds the ball to player 2. Now what we're going to do here, we're trying to get a layup now. So we're going to have player 3 run inbounds and this is going to be a dribble handoff. We are now going to have player 1 running up top and player 3 is going to use that dribble handoff. Now, at the same time, player 4 is going to run and set a back screen for player 5 so that now when player 5 is cutting, either player 3 could have taken the 3-point shot, he could pass to player 5, or he could pass to player 1 for the 3-point shot, or player 5 could continue across and maybe open in the post as well. Now, our number one option is to either hit player 5 with player 3's pass or hit player 5 with player 1's pass. Either way, he should be open. Now, in our fourth inbounds, this is a play that I ran a lot with the older team that I used to coach, the grade 10 team. We had one player who could dunk the basketball, and he was able to catch and actually do an alley-oop. This guy could jump, and he could jump high. So what we did was we had player 1 pop out, and player 1 would get the inbounds pass. Player 3 would then run inbounds, and he could be open for the 3-point shot. That is an option. However, what we want is player 2 setting a back screen on player 5, player 4 popping out to the 3-point line to free up the key, and player 5 is going to then cut back door using that screen, and this could be an alley-oop pass. If he can't do an alley-oop, it could be just as simple as a very hard pass to player 5 for the layup. And now in our fifth play is a play that many, many, many teams use. This is a very simple play, and what we're going to have is player 2 and player 1 setting a screen across. Player 5 is going to go to the post, and player 4 is going to go to the 3-point line. 3 is going to inbounds to 4, or he could also inbounds to player 5. Player 5 is our number one option for the layup. Now, what we're hoping for is, as well, if player 5 isn't open in the post, this is going to be a dribble handoff with player 3. Player 1 and player 2 are going to set a staggered screen for player 3, which could be a 3-point shot. Player 5 is going to clear out. And then this first screen, player 2 is going to roll towards the basket, and he may be open for that layup as well. He is our second option, and that 3-point shot is our third option. Now, I hope that these 5 basketball inbounds plays will help you win more games. If they do, let us know in the comments below how they work for you, and if you change them just a slight bit to make them better for your team. Anyways, let us know how you like this video as well, and hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more videos that we post every single day. And if you do subscribe, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Hey guys, so here I'm on the set with hockey coach Ethan. This is my cousin. So basically they're starting a brand new channel for hockey coaches and players, or for anybody who just likes hockey in general. So this is my cousin. Do you have anything
yes,
to say?
I am. You know, it's a brand new channel and I'm gonna be sharing my knowledge of the game. And if you like hockey, hit subscribe. I'm going to teach you some stuff that I know, and I've been playing hockey like my whole life, so.
Yeah, anyways, I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow.
Thank you.
Hello, so if you have liked this video, click over here to subscribe, or maybe over here, depending on which side I put it on. I don't know yet. Anyways, also, the opposite direction, or the opposite side, is another video you may like. So I hope to see you again in one of those next videos. Yeah.